What can I cook today? This might be very straightforward, but I wanted to know if you're married or have family. What can I cook today? I like your style, I like your logic, and it's got my attention. So I'm gonna be straightforward with you. Are you married? No, I'm not married. Do I have family? Yes, I do have family, and I'm very close with them. I've also got one brother who's also a pharmacist, which I'm very, very close with. And also, I'm very close with my extended family, who are my YouTube family, who have always supported me and sending out lots of love to you guys. Thank you. Welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. I'm excited to see what questions you have for me this week. And as always, we're going to be tackling health questions and fun questions. So let's dive in. Pfizer Anand Noor. Hello, Abraham. How can you reduce your chances of getting diabetes when it actually runs in the family? The thing is, I can't really stay away from sugary stuff because I'm a baker. Pfizer, thank you for your comment. I appreciate the comment and I appreciate your honesty. I imagine you're on about type 2 diabetes. With regards to type 2 diabetes, the majority of type 2 diabetes is preventable and it is due to lifestyle factors. In fact, a study from the NHS, or evidence from the NHS, suggests that if you reduce your weight by just 5% and do regular exercise, your chances of developing type 2 diabetes reduces by a massive 50%. So that's the first thing you need to do. But a few questions come to mind with this question. So, what's your lifestyle like? Are you exercising? If you're not exercising, why are you not exercising? You need to be doing about 30 minutes a day for at least 5 days a week with different levels of intensity. Do you smoke? Do you drink alcohol? If you do, you need to try and quit both of them because they can increase your risk of diabetes. Are you having a healthy, balanced diet? Are you eating lots of fruit? Are you eating lots of vegetable? Are you mixing this with exercise to help you reduce your belly fat? Also, I did make a video about belly fat and how to lose belly fat. I will leave a link up here and in the description below. That's a little plug bit. Also, are you eating lots of sugary foods? You need to cut down on the sugary foods. I know you say it's difficult because you're a baker, but especially if it runs in the family, this is something that you really need to cut down on. So that's my tips. I hope they help you. I will also leave more information in the description below. I've got some really good links in there for you as well. But always remember that you're awesome and you can do it. ARSD Wallace, how many cameras does he have lying around his office? ARSD, thank you for your comment. At the moment, I've got 3 cameras. When I first started, I had 1 camera and we used to do a lot of different positionings, but now we do 3. It makes life a lot easier. We can blast through filming a lot easier. But to begin with, I just had the 1. Now I've got 3 and they're all ATDs. Canon is the best camera and I highly recommend it. James J. Lee 0521. Why is it unethical to promote a product you like? James, thank you for your comment. This is from the My Best Sunscreens video on how to pick the best sunscreens. Well, James, I personally think there's a lack of honest, unbiased, evidence-based information online out there. And what I always try and do is spread a meaningful message of public health out there. And as a healthcare professional, as a trusted healthcare professional, we are obligated to give you the information based on research. By looking at research, looking at evidence, and give you the correct information. So what I will always do is give you what I think is right, the correct information. When you mix money into this and people are paying you to endorse their product, it opens up an ethical dilemma because you're getting paid to endorse a product. So how are you using those facts? Are you not giving all the facts? Are you not giving all the information? So I will always give you the correct information so you can make that decision and look after yourself properly and stay healthy and safe in the sun. 0212 Mel, I've come here from your sore throat advice. I need to stop snacking because my muffin top belly is slowly turning into a Victoria sponge. Mel, thank you for your comment. I love the way you've described belly fat. This is from the How to Lose Belly Fat video. Muffin top belly, never heard that. But then comparing it to a Victoria sponge, I mean, it's just genius. For those of you who don't know what a Victoria sponge is, then you definitely need to visit the UK and try a Victoria sponge. They are the best cakes. Apparently, I think they were named after Queen Victoria, who used to like to have them with her afternoon tea. Yeah, delicious. Also, my photographer Nadia, she makes the best Victoria sponge cake you will ever have. Mel, I'll keep you a slice. Proud Amy, when you've been doing it for so long and you realize that you're doing it wrong. Proud Amy, I like you, I like your comment. This is from the How to Use an Inhaler video. And you know, your username says Proud Amy, so you're a very proud person. And a proud person doesn't usually admit defeat. Well, this isn't defeat, but admit that they're doing something wrong. So thank you for your comment. And it's also important to remember, you know, I see so many patients, I do so many consultations with patients, and I'm asking them, okay, use your inhaler, you know, show me how to do it. And some of them get so moody about it as well because like, I know how to use my inhaler. I've been using it for 20 years. I've been using this inhaler before you were born. And I'm like, that's fine. Just use it in front of me. I just want to watch you use it. And I guarantee you, 9 times out of 10, those people are doing one or two things wrong. So this little improvement can make a massive improvement in the way that the inhaler works, in getting the medicine to the right area of the lungs, and in the overall healthcare. Looks like we've run out of time again. That's the end of this week's episode. If I haven't got back to your question or comment, please leave another one, and I'll try my best to get back to you in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember that you're awesome, and I'll see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.